Now, I want to tell you about four or three things that are just actually true. They're not actually stories, just things that happened. I talked about that abandoned league a while ago. Years ago, in rain, you could hear the catcher talking to the pitcher. It could be real quiet until something happened, and hair broke loose. Man. And one day, rain was playing Abbeville. And they had a batter on Abbeville that could just look at that ball near the end, lost it. And the only thing that he couldn't took was one of what they used to call an outshoot, a curve. And I was there one day, and this fella come up the bat, and rains ahead, one run. Abbeville got one man on base, his man at bat, great big fella. This catcher said to the pitcher, you can hear him up in the stand. He said, "Ah, that big so-and-so," only he called him what he was. "We got to watch him now. We don't want him to get on base, no. Best thing for you to did is curve him." This is in the ninth inning. The little pitcher getting kind of tired. He said, "Yeah, you gonna curve him?" He said, "Hell yeah, oh yeah." Well, he ran back, chunked that ball, flap! The hide come off of it. He lost it. That catcher stand up, that fella jogging toward first base. He said, "Didn't you hear me told you to curve him, huh?" He said, "I curve him, but it wouldn't broke." And years ago, too, in this same league, there was a scout named Tony John. He's still a scout for the Dodgers. But he and another scout had a boy in mind that was in high school playing semi-pro ball, trying to get into the abandoned league. And he went to a game that they were real hotly contested, you know, big rival, town about 16 miles apart. And he went there to scout this boy. They'd been talking to the manager about him, and the manager was proud of him because he was his son. Hell, he bound to be proud of him, you know. And he snuck in. They didn't want the boy to know that they were there to watch him scout him. And Tony John and this other scout from the Dodgers get there, and they lean up against the grandstand. When this boy's at bat, and the manager's over on third base, and he see these scouts come over there, and he left third base, and he walk over there and squat down, starts talking to the scout, and the umpire, who live in the other town, hollered, "You're out!" And the boy hadn't even struck at the ball yet. That manager jump up and say, "What you said?" He said, "The batter's out, I guarantee." He said, "What the hell you mean he's out? He ain't got a strike nor a ball two on him either." He said, "Just like I'm told you, the batter is out." He said, "How come he's out?" He said, "You talking to the scout, that's how come he's out." He said, "Where you get that?" He said, "From the rule book, that's where I get that." He said, "Get that rule book, I want to see that." "What rule book you talking about?" And that little umpire beat himself on the chest and say, "You looking at the rule book." Two more little things that just happened, that's all. I got a friend named Murphy Brown, just barely does speak English, and it's wonderful to hear him talk, and I think so much of him. And he loves to, well, he's a doggone good hunter. Good hunter. In fact, he hunts 13 months every year. And last deer season, down in the swamp where he lives, where it's plumb against the law to kill a doe deer, a female deer, old Murphy killed him one. He dragged it up to a fence, and there's a game warden in full uniform that Murphy ain't never seen in his life. And they're all trying to catch him all the time. He said, "Hello there." Game warden said, "What you got there?" He said, "A doe deer, that's what I got there. Help me get him across the fence, huh?" The game warden said, "Who killed that deer, that doe?" He said, "Me, I'll kill it. Help me get him across the fence because I got another one down the wood. You watch this one, I'm gonna go get that one down the wood." Game warden said, "All right, I'll watch that one." Murphy left, he ain't been back yet. One more little quick is the true story. This is true. Years ago in Louisiana, we used to have a lot of good boxing teams, you know, in the high school. And they had the high school tournaments. And boy, I wanted to tell you, it was something. I used to go to all of them. I judged some of them. I even refereed a couple of the fights, got the hair knocked out of me a couple of times. But when them young boys is flailing, they don't care who they flail on, you hear them? And I've been to Flailee a couple of times. And I never will forget. They had the state tournament, and Mamu had a fine boxing team. And they had an old boy that would fight everybody in town. But he did not know how to box, no. He just didn't know how to box. But he always asked the coach, "Coach, give me a chance. Let me get in there and fight. Let me get in there and fight." Coach said, "Well, you don't know how to fight. How many?" "Oh, yeah, hell yeah, I can fight." He said, "Well, I got a good heavyweight. I don't want to mess up there." Well, they had the tournament, and Coach went there. He's not from Mamou. He didn't spoke no French. He went there, and the heavyweight got sick. He sent for this boy, said, "You want to fight?" He said, "Hell yeah, I did it, man. I know how." He said, "All right. Get in there and fight. I hate like hell to forfeit a fight." Well, he got in there, and that fella liked to beat him to death, throwing them gloves at him by the basket full. And he come by the corner, and he said something in French to the coach, and the coach said, "Get in there and fight." And he come back again, and he said something more in French. Coach said, "What he said to one of the seconds? You spoke French. What he said?" He said, "Coach, if you don't throw that towel in here pretty soon, he's going to jump that little old tree barbed wire fence, I guarantee." You know, they used to play all the high school games down in the Mississippi River and some of the places in Southwest Louisiana on Sunday. But when the Oilers got a football team, they quit playing them on Southwest Louisiana on Sunday. They started playing them on Wednesday, and they come see the Oilers play. In Southeast Louisiana, they quit playing on Sunday and started going to see the Saints play on Sunday, or to try to play both of them teams. And I don't know whether this kid and these two kids were talking about the Saints or the Oilers. But he said, "You know, I know what's wrong with them. They're giving the signals away." He said, "What the hell you meant, give them signals away?" He said, "You go to the game." He said, "Hell yeah, I go to the game." He said, "You notice when you come out of the huddle, three of them backfield men are laughing like hell and one of them pale as a ghost."